Au revoir! No, no! What have they done to you? Au revoir! Au revoir!
Is that you, my lord? You seem rather flustered.
Because of you, you imbecile! What in the seven hells happened to you?
My apologies. Some few of the guests expressed a wish to leave, and I implored them to stay. It would seem they took issue with my request.
Gods forgive me. If I had only been more careful with my words.
Do not blame yourself, my lord. I know. I know that you and your brother have Ishgard's best interests at heart. That poor woman. She lives in the past, clinging to the memories of the lost. But the future holds so much promise, so much joy. And you know that better than any.
Onua!
Calm yourself. The boy will live. But it's imperative we get him inside and into the care of a Kairujin without delay.
Oh, we were so close! Why does it all have to fall to pieces? Don't they want to live in peace? Don't they want to be happy? We all want the same thing! And still it falls to pieces! Tell me, what was I supposed to do? Someone, anyone, tell me, what was I supposed to do?
Stop looking to others. You make your choice and you live with the consequences.
And what would you know about consequences? You who always know just what to say and just what to do. Your every deed is greeted with a round of applause.
You know nothing about me. I have fought tooth and nail for the people I hold dear. Done everything in my power to save them. And I have failed. Learn to live with it. I have.
We'll be right back. Lord Commander, if I may, I wish to speak with you before the Grand Melee.
Proceed.
How do you do it, my lord? How do you lead with such certainty when so many of our countrymen will not hear of peace with the Dravanians? Some of them hate you almost as much as the dragons themselves. They decry you as a patricide in the streets. They even tried to kill you, for God's sakes. Yet still, you march on, undaunted, where no archbishop dared to tread. What is your secret? Where do you find the strength?
For centuries, our nation has been punished for the sins of our forefathers. If our punishment is to end, I believe we must right the wrongs of antiquity and move forward as a nation united. Needless to say, my father did not share this opinion. He did not believe the people strong enough to bring about their own deliverance, trusting only in himself. Tyranny seemed to him the only solution. But I have faith in the people, Lord Emanuelain. I have faith that they will weather this storm and overcome every trial we set before them. Many have fought and died to see this blight upon our nation's history cleansed, and I would not let their sacrifices be in vain. Though we invite reprisals, the risk is worth the reward.
I want to believe. I do. Lord Commander, through my careless orders, a pall has been cast over these proceedings, and I beg the opportunity to make amends. I, Emanuelain de Forton, do hereby request leave to take part in the Grand Melee.
Who am I to deny such a heartfelt plea? We would be honored to have you join the fray, my lord.
You'll take charge of the Ishgardian forces.
For all my other responsibilities, I am still Lord Commander of the Temple Knights, and I would not soon yield this duty to another.
The esteemed Sir Emeric leading the Temple Knights and the Watch into battle along with my youngest. I could wish for no more.
Then you wish for too little, my lord. There is another who might yet join the fray. An indispensable ally to whom we owe much and more. An adventurer beholden to none who nevertheless chose to champion our cause, who has shared in our suffering and in our glory. A warrior without equal, who I am privileged to call a friend. There is no one I would rather have fighting by my side. I ask this in full knowledge of your obligations and will not think less of you should you refuse. But if your conscience will allow it, might you oblige me, my friend, one more time. Together we shall give the people a spectacle for the ages, a celebration to mark the dawning of a new era.
Thank you.
Let all here present heed well the rules of engagement. For the honor and the glory of Ishgard.
All is ready then. Very well. Let's go.
Did he win? Then we...
Victory is ours! Ishgard! Ishgard! Well fought! Well fought, my friend! You truly are the warrior of warriors.
Thank the Fury you were on our side.
Oh, my lungs are burning, and I can barely stand. I didn't think I could do it, but then I did. We did. We faced the Alliance's best, and together, with one heart, with one purpose, we prevailed. After 1,000 years of hardship, of strife and bloodshed, we are strong enough to rise to any challenge, be it on the battlefield or beyond. The future holds so much promise, so much joy. We need only show them the way.
Magnificent display, Sir Knight. While doubtless less than pleased, I am quite sure the Grand Companies are honored to have been bested by such valiant warriors.
The honor was ours, Your Grace.
I am pleased to see that Ishgard's proud martial tradition is being upheld. When the time comes, I trust you will fight alongside your brothers and sisters in the Eorzean Alliance with the same fervor you displayed in opposing them. I note that our friend elected to take the field in Ishgardian colors.
At my behest, Your Grace, if we have given offense, the blame lies with me.
Not, Sir Knight. It was a surprise, nothing more. And any hint of ill feeling was thoroughly dispelled by the spectacle of our mutual friend's duel with General Raubarn. On the subject of surprises, I could not help but marvel at the passion and unity of purpose displayed by your countrymen, given the troubling reports we have received of late.
I shall take that as a compliment, Your Grace. The events to which you allude are the price of change. The end of the Dragonsong War marks the beginning of a new era for our nation, and for the people, high and lowborn alike, who will lead her into the future.
Ah, yes. The people. Change is indeed a perilous thing. For we who seek it, and they who fear it. I shall pray for Ishgard, and for you.
Well, that made for a refreshing change. Congratulations on your victory, by the way. Ishgardians certainly seem happy with themselves. I, for my part, am merely glad you did not strain anything in the process of single-handedly winning the battle for them.
Ugh.
is but a scratch, I assure you. And I will not suffer you to worry over me. Not when we have a dozen far more important concerns. Make that 24. Still, as Ystola never tires of telling me, we can but face them head on, one at a time.
One day at a time. As Minfilia would have done.
My lord!
Honor while, my boy. Shouldn't you be in bed?
Thank you for your concern, my lord. But I have largely recovered from my ordeal, and I have naught but several scars to show for it, which I have been told some women may find appealing.
I see. And to think I was worried sick over you.
I'm not sure I understand, my lord.
Well, let's put that theory to the proof, shall we?
My lord?
would seem that a great many things have occurred in my absence. I thought I might begin to make amends by welcoming you in person.
The messengers spared not their chocobos to bring us word of your victory in the grand melee. I cannot well describe our elation when we heard the news. It called to mind the day we rejoined the Eorzean Alliance, and I glimpsed hope rekindled in the eyes of the people.
The Fury herself ushers us into a new era. Sir Emmerich, the time is now.
Aye, that it is. Reconvene the conference and summon Vidofnir to Falcon's Nest. We will make peace with Hreisvelga's brood and hasten this bloody war to its end.
Yes, Lord Commander.
I will send word to Artoirel and bid him resume preparations. Emanuele, you will place yourself at your brother's disposal. He will be glad of your assistance.
No stopping it now, is there? We should inform Ystola and the others.
My dear friend, I doubt I will ever be able to thank you enough. But when the conference is successfully concluded, I damn well mean to try.